this Linux tutorial, we'll go over command line file operations with MV, CP, and RM. These commands give you much more fine-tuned control over just using a file manager. Let's get started. We'll first go over how to move a file. Let's say you'd like to move this video file to the desktop. We'll type MV, the file name, and the destination folder. This is as if you dragged the file to the desktop in the file manager. Passing MV multiple files followed by the destination folder lets us move both videos back. I'm gonna CD into the parent home directory with the salsa folder. To move all of them in this folder to the desktop, I can use MV star, which is a bash wildcard symbol for all the files in this folder. Remember that tilde stands for my home folder, which contains the desktop folder. What if I want to move back just the files ending in .mov? I can use MV desktop star .mov back to the current folder I'm in. Remember that the single dot references my current folder, which saves me typing it out. File names are also case sensitive in Linux, so in this case, lowercase mov won't work. Using the star wildcard is like selecting multiple files and dragging them to a target folder. MV is also a common way to rename files in Linux. Suppose I wanted to rename img0210. I can use MV to do this as long as the destination file is in the same folder. If you use the tag V flag, which stands for verbose, MV will print the name of every file moved or renamed, which is nice since it gives you some feedback. By the way, what we just did there was double-click the file name to highlight it, and paste with middle-click to save some typing. Now, understand that MV is a destructive command, since it can overwrite things if the destination folder has a file with the same name as the source file you're moving or renaming. On the desktop, I've got a text file and a Python script. If I use MV with no flags, I'll lose the script. To avoid this, MV offers several protection mechanisms. One is the TACIN flag, which stands for no clobbering, which doesn't move the file if it detects a possible overwrite, which is the case here since generate.py exists. If I run MV with the TACI flag, which stands for interactive, it'll ask me if I want to overwrite the file by typing Y and hitting enter. Anything else will skip the move. The third flag is TACB, which stands for backup. This will back up the file that would have been overwritten by adding a tilde to the end. I can rename the backed up file again to restore it. To avoid using all these flags, simply make sure the destination files don't have the same name when you're moving. Now, there's slight behavior differences for MV when you're moving folders. In both my home folder and the desktop, I have two empty videos folders. If I move the one in my home to the desktop or using dot, my current directory, it'll replace the empty folder. If the destination folder isn't empty, say if I put this mp4 in there, the command won't overwrite the folder since it contains files. Note that if you type the name of the destination folder, the command will work because you're moving one folder into the other. It will not replace or rename the source folder though, if that's what you're trying to do. Let's move on to copying with CP. If I want to make a backup copy of this script, simply type cp generate.py and give the copied file a new name, since you'll get an error otherwise. You can specify a path to the source and destination as well if you're not in the same folder. In this case, you can just use the folder path to keep the same name or specify a new name after the path. For copying folders, you need to specify the TACR flag, which stands for recursive, otherwise it'll fail. Recursive means it'll copy all the subdirectories and files inside. If I change the TACV for verbose flag, it'll show you what's actually copied. CP is a destructive command, just like MV, and will overwrite destination files that already exist with the same name. Just like before, you can specify the TACIN flag to never clobber, TACI for an interactive prompt, and TACB to make a backup of the overwritten files. You can pass multiple files to CP and copy them all somewhere, which in this case is our current or desktop folder. This command won't work though, since all of the files have the same name and will overwrite each other. There's often tricks to work through situations like this if you dig around in the man pages. Notice that the TACTAC backup flag is just longhand for TACB and accepts an argument. If I search for it and cycle forward, pressing the N key, we can specify a numbered suffix for overwritten files. Let me press Q to quit and give it a try. There we go. I copied multiple files in different folders with the same name to the desktop folder. The special flag numbered them all so they wouldn't overwrite each other. This isn't particularly useful for just a couple files, but imagine if you had hundreds. Lastly, let me cover the RM or remove command. I can remove a single file or multiple files with it. Using a star lets me remove all files matching this wildcard string, though it's wise to use the TAC-I interactive flag for verifying what you're deleting. Unlike deleting something in the file manager, which moves it to the trash, RM is permanent deletion. To delete a folder, you need to use the TAC-R recursive flag, similar to CP. Chaining together the TAC-V for verbose flags shows you what's been removed. Use TAC-I to prompt only once before recursively removing a folder to protect against mistakes. So that's it for file operations in the command line. As you can see, there's some instances where doing things in the terminal might be faster and easier than in the file manager, and vice versa. All you need is to spend a bit of time practicing every day to get fully comfortable. Hit that like button if you enjoyed this Linux tutorial, subscribe if you aren't already, and let me know what commands you like to learn in the comments below. See you soon.